Welcome to Computer Vision. Today we're going to, this might be the last one of the lectures on just sort of this collection of stuff that it maybe not be thought of as core computer vision, but just stuff that I thought you guys should be exposed to one way or the other. I also want to give a shout out to Kelsey Hawkins, who helped produce some of the material here. So that's opposed to all the other people that I stole things from, since Kelsey's actually my student and put this talk together. I thought I would do that. But today I want to talk to you a little bit about depth sensing. I would say that this is tremendously driven by the fact that there's a lot of work recently in computer vision dealing for robotics. The recovery of depth previously had been a bit back in the 60s, 70s, 80s, had been a big focus of computer vision. Then things sort of moved away into more certain motion things, labeling stuff, processing of video to extract stuff, and of course processing all the images on the web. But in the last decade or so, with the growth of robotics, there's this goal to be able to visually extract information from the scene for a robot. And a lot of that information that's desired is about the geometry of what's out there. Where is there stuff? Where is there not stuff? What things are on the table? How would I pick them up off the table? So that's sort of given a resurgence to the interest in recovering geometry that's out there. And of course, recovering geometry is a fundamentally difficult problem in computer vision. You know, here's a picture. You look at this monocularly and you see a surface with some geometry on there. There's a certain ambiguity, perhaps, as to what's in front and what's behind. But there's a question of, well, how do you get a single image to understand this kind of stuff? You, of course, have all these problems that image intensity changes as a function of the illumination. But here's an image of same scene lit from different colored light. And of course, it provides a different image to be processed. And yet the geometry is identical. We've talked about this before, challenges of scale. Here's an interesting picture. When you look at this table, you see a bunch of white bowls, cups, et cetera, whatever. But if we actually were to sort of take a look at just in this patch right there, clearly, there's not a whole lot of interesting variation going on there for image processing to handle. And, you know, somehow it basically has to be able to somehow figure out from the basic extraction of this shape that there's this cylinder on the table. And that's generally a hard thing to do. We also have trouble that color is not all that discriminative sometimes of what's there. So there's sort of a similarity between the foreground and the background. What we'd really like is we'd like some representation, something that gave us the shape directly. And so that we would see something that looks like this, and you know, won't surprise you that this is where we're headed. So here is a bunch of objects on a table. And you know, it'd be nice if the system could just know that this was one surface and that this was another surface and these were the objects. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna talk about 3D sensing.